CBSE Biology Class 10 Chapter 8 How do organisms reproduce? Part 1B. Let us learn the biology chapters through questions and answers, which most of the students prefer. Note that PG here is per page, PR per paragraph in your test book. Questions are given in yellow color, while answers are in white color. Why is variation beneficial to the population or species but not necessarily for an individual? If a population of reproducing organisms were suited to a particular niche, and if the niche were drastically altered, the population could be wiped out. Thus, variation is beneficial to population or species but not necessarily for individuals. What is the basis of evolution? The surviving cells are similar to the other cells, but certainly different from each other. Basic event in reproduction is the creation of a DNA copy. Variation in DNA copying during reproduction is the inbuilt tendency. This inbuilt tendency for variation in DNA copying during reproduction is the basis for evolution. The more there are variations, the more there are chances for survival of species. Difference between habitat and niche. Habitat is the place where organisms are found. The niches are the well-defined places in the respective ecosystem for populations of organisms. Habitat is like address of organisms. Niche is not just address but includes profession or function also. Both tiger and deer found in the forest. Habitat. But tiger is a predator and deer a prey. Niche. What is the importance of DNA copying in reproduction? Consider this example to understand it. If there were a population of bacteria living in temperate waters, and if the water temperature were to be increased by global warming, most of these bacteria would die. But if the few variants resistant to heat would survive and grow further, thus if some variations were to be present due to DNA copying during reproduction in a few individuals in these populations, there would be some chance for them to survive. Variation is thus useful for the survival of species over time. How niches may change? Give three examples. Yes, niches can change because of reasons beyond the control of the organisms. Any kind of change in the surrounding could make change in niches. Here are a few examples. Number 1. Temperatures on Earth can go up or down. Number 2. Water levels can vary. Number 3. There could be meteorite hits. How variation is useful for the survival of a species over time. If there were a population of bacteria living in cool temperate waters, and then due to global warming, if the water temperature were turned warmer, most of these bacteria may die. But the few variants resistant to heat would survive and grow further. Variation is thus very useful for the survival of species over time. Which organisms can reproduce by cell division? For unicellular organisms, cell division or fission leads to the creation of new individuals. Many different patterns of fission have been observed in different unicellular organisms. How the binary fission in bacteria, protozoa, amoeba and Leishmania differs. Many bacteria and protozoa simply split into two equal halves during cell division. In organisms such as amoeba, the splitting of the two cells during division can take place in any plane. But in Leishmania, which cause the disease Kala-Jaur, which have a whip-like structure at one end of the cell, binary fission occurs in a definite orientation in relation to these structures. Why is DNA copying an essential part of the process of reproduction? If some variations were to be present due to DNA copying during reproduction in a few individuals in the populations, there would be some chance for them to survive in case of any drastic change in the nature. Therefore, variation due to DNA copying is an essential part of the process of reproduction. It is definitely useful for the survival of species over time. How a single cell organism can travel multicellular human body during malarial disease? One single celled organism, such as the malarial parasite named Plasmodium, divide into many daughter cells simultaneously by multiple fission. Thus, just a single organism, such as a malarial parasite, may reproduce a large number of parasites in no time and then can travel multicellular human body causing malarial disease. State the differences between binary fission and multiple fission. Binary fission, from one cell, two cells are formed. In multiple fission, from one cell, many cells are formed. Binary fission examples are bacteria, protozoa, amoeba, Leishmania. Multiple fission examples are the malarial parasite Plasmodium.